Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another Learning Glass studio session. Today, we'll talk about chemical equilibrium, specifically applied to the combustion reaction or products thereof. So, chemical chemical equilibrium among combustion products. So, what do I mean by that? Let's say you were burning a fuel to run an engine, and like you had a cylinders of this engine, and they exhausted, you know, like you have these cylinders, and then it goes to your tailpipe, you know, the exhaust valves, and then you have your tailpipe. So here is a fuel-air mixture that burns. Then when it burns, it has combustion products of the chemical reaction. So, in some combustion problems, we start from the fuel, know how much fuel and air is there. From that starting point, you can figure out what's happening in the combustion products. So, for equilibrium problems, you need a mass balance and you need an energy balance. And you need an equilibrium analysis. So, in this problem today, we're going to be given that starting from a known that you know in the exhaust you have 1 mole of carbon monoxide and 1 mole of oxygen in this stream at 3000 Kelvin. So it's a very hot flame, I mean a very hot stream. The combustion's over, but the product stream is very hot with 1 mole of CO and 1 mole of O2. That's our given starting point. Because of that, what we're going to see is that the equilibrium is among these two, and as we know, these two are products of dissociation of CO2. Then it's going to be related to this fuel-air mixture. If we're given the fuel-air mixture, we would have to figure that out first. But in this problem, we're only given the product stream, which is what we need for the chemical equilibrium. And in fact, we're given the temperature. So because we're given the temperature, we don't need the energy balance. We already know the temperature. That's what usually the energy balance is for. Because of we have these two starting point then this mass balance is, the fuel stream is not needed. And this problem is based on product stream. Product stream. So we still need the chemical equilibrium. Okay. So let me erase this diagram here. Okay, going back to this, we're starting out state one in our, it is state one, but we don't need the energy balance. So, so it's going to be 1 mole of CO and 1 mole of O2 at 3000 Kelvin. Let's say T equals 3000. So the question is, what is the equilibrium composition? So whenever you do some equilibrium analysis, you have to define what can happen, what are the possibilities that can happen. So as we discussed in class, for combustion reactions, for a hydrocarbon fuel, that hydrocarbon fuel, in theory, the best possible situation would be you completely oxidize the fuel to CO2, and the hydrogen in the fuel goes to water, H2O. But because of chemical equilibrium, you have incomplete combustion, and that has some balance between CO2 and CO, and H2O and H2. So in this particular mixture we're given, there's no hydrogen there. So there's not going to be any water dissociation equilibrium back and forth. It's only going to be the equilibrium reaction of CO2. So that's what we're gonna, that's our starting point. We have our mixture that we're gonna analyze the equilibrium with. We can do a mass balance, but the fuel's gone. It's only CO and O2 that we're starting with based on this given problem. We know the temperature, so we don't need an energy balance. So we know that this is an equilibrium limited product stream. So the next question is, if we need to know the equilibrium composition, meaning how much is in the stream after equilibrium is established. So here's our starting point. Equilibrium is not established. Thermal equilibrium is established. We're going to assume that the temperature stays at 3000 Kelvin. Once the temperature stays at 3000 Kelvin and we have these two things, what else can happen? Well, according to our knowledge of combustion chemistry, thermochemistry, we know that CO and O2 is involved in this process where at high temperatures in a combustion reaction, you should form some CO2. And then when it goes under a high temperature stream, there's some possibilities based on the equilibrium balance where that CO2 will dissociate to CO and O2. So we're given this here. And then we have to pull from our chemistry knowledge of equilibrium limited processes and then analyze what can happen if this is a possibility at this temperature from this starting condition. Okay, so this is the define. So on combustion, it can be CO2 dissociation, water dissociation, or both. Here it's just CO2. Okay. And the way that we're going to analyze this is in terms of this equilibrium constant as a function of temperature. So if we write this down, it would be Kp. Kp as a function of T equals the partial pressure of CO to the 1, the partial pressure of O2 to the 1/2, and the partial pressure of CO2 to the 1. And if we convert using the ideal gas law, partial pressures to mole fractions, that would be CO to the 1, mole fraction of O2 to the 1/2, mole fraction of CO2 to the 1. But partial pressure is some component times the total pressure equals the partial pressure. So when we can do that conversion, that there's going to be some total pressure over some reference. This is a 1 atmosphere. And you're going to add up all these exponents. It'll be 1 minus plus 1/2 minus 1. Or another thing that's useful is instead of using mole fractions, instead of using mole fractions, we can use total moles. So mole fraction as well is the moles of one component over the total moles. And if we do that, it'll be similar. So just directly plugging this into here will give us another expression. It'll be the moles of CO raised to the 1, the moles of O2 raised to the 1/2, and the moles of CO2 raised to the 1. But because we're keeping this and then converting this to moles, but to do that, you're going to have each of these components that I wrote down, but each of these components has the total moles in there. So this would be, do I have it here? I guess it'll be here. Well, let's put it down here. Actually, it would be here. So it would be the total moles. This, if we put this down here, this would be a 1, because it's in the denominator. Put this here, this would be plus 1/2. and then this is minus one. Then you would keep this pressure term as well. So that would be 1/2. So this is all in terms of partial pressures. We're just converting it into other units. So this would be the moles of CO raised to the 1, the moles of O2 raised to the 1/2, and then you have the CO2 raised to the 1, and then the total moles to the 1/2. Okay, so this is Kp, meaning that the equilibrium compositions in terms of partial pressures at a given temperature, but all we did was convert partial pressure to mole fraction, and then we converted mole fraction to moles to give us this expression in terms of moles, and I'll show you why. But another point is that Kp has this ratio of concentrations. What does it mean? It's saying that the concentrations that we figure out in here is you're assuming the numbers you get in here, it's after you reach equilibrium. So in this process, we're stating that we start off with 1 mole of CO2 and 1 mole of O2, and it's that we're implying there that this mixture is not at equilibrium. It pretty much can't be at equilibrium because we know that at high temperatures, this reaction happens. So there has to be some amount of CO2 in the mixture to reach equilibrium. It's going to be some competition between the left side of this and the right side of this equilibrium reaction. And at very high temperatures, theoretically, you go towards completion, meaning no CO2 left, all dissociation. But the question is, exactly what are these number? How does this starting mixture change when it reaches chemical equilibrium? That's given by this ratio here, which is different than your starting conditions. So if we were given the fuel composition air-fuel-air mixture, that would be our like anchor point to do a mass balance and to tie in how this starting input mixture has a certain amount of carbons, has a certain amount of hydrogens, has a certain amount of oxygen. Usually there's excess oxygen, and that would be a way to combine to tie all the atoms together that is needed to tie all the molecules together. Okay, so this is our equilibrium constant at Kp at 3000 Kelvin. That's what this is. And if you know this equilibrium constant, which we will find actually in the tables, you can use this to have this left-hand side defined, and then go use that to solve the right-hand side. So first, let's do the mass balance. In this case, it's based on the product stream. And we know that if this is the equilibrium reaction, that our starting point is that we started off with 1 mole of CO plus 1 mole of O2 is going to go towards, let me write it over here. So this is the chemical equilibrium. Then this is going to be the mass balance based on the product stream. Is that we started off with this, then it has to go to some mixture of all of these things at equilibrium. So it's going to be some amount of CO2 formed in the product stream of the combustion. So it's going to be the product of the products. We have out of the tailpipe of a combustor, we have this. Because of equilibrium, there's going to be some balance between these three molecules here. So some X amount of CO2, then because we're only assuming these two possibilities, then if this is forming, then the balance of that carbon species will be CO. Then there's going to be some amount of oxygen. There's one mole starting off, but because of equilibrium, some of it is going to go to CO2. So we have to figure that out, the balance between your starting one mole and the remaining after going to CO2. That's the mass balance. This energy balance is basically done because we're given the temperature. And that would be based on the first law to figure that out. Because we're given the temperature, we don't need that step. Okay, so this would be the split X. In the way that we set it up, X is the split between CO2 and CO, only assuming that these are the only two possibilities. Okay. So if we do the carbon balance on the carbon atom, that would be one on the left side has to equal 1 times X on the right side plus 1 minus X on the left side and the right side. So it is, it's just X plus 1 minus X equals 1. These two, so that doesn't tell us anything. But the oxygen balance is going to allow us to reduce our variables from beta and X to only X. So the way that we set this up, we're saying that CO and O2 is our starting point. So the CO has one oxygen. The O2 has two oxygens. So the oxygen atom, there's one in the one mole of CO. The oxygen atom, there's two oxygen atoms in one mole of O2. That has to balance with the right side, which is 2x in the CO2 plus 1 minus x in the CO stream plus 2 beta. So if we solve for beta, we can use this oxygen balance to reduce the variables from X in beta only to X. And then we can use it in here. Okay, so this would be 3 equals 2X plus 1 minus X plus 2 beta. What you should get is that 2 equals X plus 2 beta. So beta equals 2 minus X over 2. All right. This overall mass balance allows us to show how much these three species are in there, and then we reduced it from beta and X to just X. So that's good. Okay, so we're getting closer to organizing this. So let's continue this analysis by filling out this KP ratio. We started off with KP because it's in the gas phase. We use partial pressure to quantify this equilibrium constant in terms of KP. Then we converted partial pressures to mole fraction. Then we converted mole fractions to mole. And that mole allows us to connect this mass balance reaction we define here, because it's all in terms of moles, not partial pressures. Up here. Okay. So we have X to represent the split between CO2 and CO, beta to represent the oxygen at equilibrium composition. Then we eliminated beta in terms of X. Now we can start filling out this ratio. So the moles, equilibrium composition. So this is the way that we drew this mass balance. Was that this was the starting point, or state one in our reference point. It would have been state two in the mass balance. Either way, this would be the before equilibrium. And here, this is at equilibrium. This only applies at equilibrium. This only means something. Chemical equilibrium. So all of these partial pressures or mole fractions or moles that we use in here, it means that those are the values at equilibrium, chemical equilibrium. And it has to be balanced by this KP value, this equilibrium constant. So the equilibrium constant, composition, if we find the moles of CO, well, the way that we defined it in this reaction, it's X, I think. Yeah. Moles of CO equals X. The moles of CO2, let me make that smaller. One minus X, and the moles of O2 equals beta, which equals It's this. How can we simplify this? It's 1/2 2 minus X, yeah. So that at equilibrium, these have to apply. Then the total moles. N. Equals X plus 1 minus X plus 1/2 2 minus X. That is, these cancel out. It's 2 minus X. One half of 2 is 1, plus 1, that's 2. One half of x is minus x, minus 1 half x. These cancel out.
So it's minus 1 half x.
Or you can
say,
that's the total moles. So that's all we need here. We could have expressed it in terms of mole fractions, but this is basically the same thing. The total moles from this mass balance reaction, it's all of these at the equilibrium mixture. We eliminated x, so adding all these together gives us 1 half 4 minus x. I mean, we eliminated beta in terms of x. So all of these added together, and then all of these individually, that's what the equilibrium constant is made out of. And then this is effective. I'm sort of writing this in terms of mole fraction. We wrote this into total moles. So the total moles that we found here is this, and then the moles of each component is this. So we're ready to plug these in. So Kp, at 3,000 Kelvin equals,
why is it 1 minus X?
Oh yeah, CO's first. Oh, I messed this up. This is CO2 at the top. So that's CO, this is CO2. X is CO2. 1 minus X is CO. Beta is O2. We solve for beta here. Okay. Now, the CO2 is at the bottom. So at the top here, the first one is CO. That would be 1 minus X raised to the 1. Then you have this oxygen one. That's all raised to the 1 half. Then we have the CO2 in total moles at the bottom. This would be X. Yeah, this would be X raised to the 1. Then you have this total moles raised to the 1 half. Then you have this pressure term to the 1 half. Now what? Well, we have this established, known, important chemical equilibrium reaction called CO2 dissociation, where at high temperatures, if you have CO2 involved, it's going to have this equilibrium between oxygen and CO, depending on the temperature. So we're saying, okay, if we're at equilibrium at this temperature, what's going to happen? Well, you need to know the number to put here. This is a constant, meaning that at one temperature, this number always stays the same. How do you find it? From tables. So this would be table A27. You would find that at one atmosphere, we're assuming we're at one atmosphere in this problem, in the tailpipe, this Kp would be 0.3. 2724. That's what the equilibrium constant is. So let me scoot it down a little bit. This would be equal 0.32724.
equals, let me simplify this a little bit. This would be 1 minus x. Is going to be 1 atmosphere over 1 atmosphere to the 1 half. So that term simplifies, assuming the pressure is at 1. Okay, so that becomes a nonlinear equation in x. So it's some constant on the left side equals some nasty polynomial-ish thing on the right side that you can solve with Newton's method, graphing method, TI-82 method, MATLAB method. It's a nasty algebra problem, algebra 2 problem, but it's solvable because you have one equation, one unknown. Okay? So, or should I write this answer here? Yeah. So if you solve for this, let's say Newton's method or trial and error method, you should find that x equals 0.6595. What is that? Well, physically, it's the proportions of fractions split between CO2 and CO at equilibrium at 3000 Kelvin. That's the physical meaning of that. The split between these two carbon-containing components. Because of the mass balance, you can also use that to find the beta, the oxygen that's in the equilibrium stream at 3000 Kelvin. So there's some physical meaning to this. It's not the moles of one component. It's the how they're all tied together at equilibrium. Based on the mass balance, we can tie them all together. So X is a split between these two, and it's also coupled to the oxygen. Then, plugging those all in to here, so the total moles of CO2 is literally this. You start off with 1 mole of CO. At 3000 Kelvin, it literally turns into 0.695 of CO2 because of equilibrium reaction that's known. Then the remaining of that, it's whatever this 3.534 moles of CO2. Then, because there's some O2 action in there, then the moles of O2 would be 2 minus this, so that would be like 1.35-ish. Divided by half, so 0.65-ish moles. So X is actually, beta is actually similar to X in number, if I'm doing that right, I think so. 1.35, yeah. Yeah, similar, but not exactly the same, but similar as X would be beta. So those are the moles. Then the mole fractions would be divided by this. So the mole fraction in the stream is of CO2 is 40%. The mole fraction of CO is 20%. And the mole fraction of O2 has to be 20% by mass, by or 40%. Then, because of partial pressures, y times the total is the partial pressure. The partial pressure of CO2 equals 0.4 atmospheres. So the partial pressure of CO2 equals 0.4 atmosphere. The partial pressure of CO equals 0.2 atmospheres. If we're assuming the one atmosphere is given, so, all that for that. So what we did was we applied a mass balance saying that we know our starting condition of this analysis, 1 mole of CO and 1 mole of O2 at 3,000 Kelvin. Because of the 3,000 Kelvin, we didn't need the energy balance. But this mass balance allowed us to tie the starting carbon and oxygen into, assuming there's some known equilibrium reaction of CO2 dissociation, then that means that even though you only started with CO in the beginning, we know there's going to be at equilibrium some CO2. And from our starting condition, we define a split in CO and CO2, and then beta would be the oxygen. But because of the mass balance, we can combine couple all them together into just the X. And then looking up the equilibrium of constant of this well-known reaction here, looked up the equilibrium constant at the given temperature and known pressure, that gave us, or the pressure, it's indirect. It's only depending on temperature. This became a number that we can pull out of the table, and then we solve this nonlinear equation to get everything we needed, which is the mole fractions, or the moles, or the partial pressures, they're all coupled together. So, that's all we had today. I'll see you guys next time. Thank you.